Hello students, how are you? I hope you all are good. Okay, so after a long time, I will be here in front of you for about our whatever JEE chemistry. Okay, class A2 JEE, we are going to discuss here our whatever major test paper discussion. In that, as you know, our which topic for this? Yes, solutions. Which topic? Solutions. So in this solutions topic, you discuss so many things, you studied so many things. Okay, in that molarity, normality, then mole fraction, ppm, parts per million, then our colligative properties, that is first relative lowering of vapor pressure, okay, then depression in freezing point, elevation in boiling point, osmotic pressure, then after that what, Wontoff factor, in that you discuss association and dissociation also, okay. Now here we are going to discuss whatever our today's paper. Obviously it will good whatever our paper, JEE paper of our chemistry solution topic. So we will discuss here question number 26. Okay, JEE question number 26 we are going to discuss here. So seeing that, about your major paper discussion, class A2, JEE. First question, the normality of 2.3 molar H2SO4 solution. Normality of 2.3 molar H2SO4. So, as you know, one basic formula. So, here normality we are going to discuss. So, that basic formula is here. Normality is equal to, okay, whatever molarity into what? Valency. Okay, into what, beta? Valency. So already they give 2.3 molar into valency of your whatever sulfuric acid. Yes, 2 only. So beta here 2.3 into 2, how much you will get? 4.6 normal. Okay, already 2.3 molar they give. So valency is what? Understood. Valency your 2. So you will get answer what? 4.6 normal. So it is very much easy. So your option is what, beta? Yes, your option is what, your B. Understood how it came. So we will move towards our next, that is our question number 27. Now see here in question number 27, what we are going to discuss in that, the molarity of solution made by mixing 50 ml of concentrated sulfuric acid. 50 ml of concentrated sulfuric acid. So that whatever that 36 normal they gave in bracket. So it is what, beta? Commercial normality. 36 normal. Okay. With a 50 ml of water each. So as you know, yes, the molarity of solution by mixing whatever final volume also. Means H2SO4 with water, we have to discuss. Okay, so with the help of which formula? Simple, N1V1 is equal to what, beta? N2V2. So normality they give, yes, 36. Understood. So V1 also they give. Initial volume, how much that? 50. Okay, N2 we have to calculate. Into how much final volume? 50 plus 50, 100. Understood. So, into beta, what will come? 36 into 50 divided by what? Simply 100. So then you will get what answer? Yes, after solving you will get here what? 18 answer. But they give what? Molarity of solution. Okay, so for molarity of solution, yes, see here, suppose how much here we calculate normality. So beta, 18 normal H2SO4, so how much it will come? Okay, how much it will come? So it will come nearly 9 molar H2SO4. Their molarity how much? 9 molar. It is a half. Means whenever we are taking in practical also, okay, that we will discuss in our practical lecture. Okay, whatever your 4 normal H2SO4, suppose you are taking 4 normal of H2SO4, so having molarity how much? 2 molar H2SO4, like that. Understood? Because of their valencies we discuss now only. Understood? So see here, so what will be your answer? Yes, your answer is what? Your C option. Understood? Option is what? C. Okay, so it is very much easy to find out. Okay, now next we will discuss question number 28. So see in question number 28, brother. In question number 28, the mole fraction, okay, the mole fraction of the solute, the mole fraction of solute in 1 molar aqueous solution, in 1 molar aqueous solution. So beta, 1 mole aqueous solution they want. Okay, so beta, how much here? Actual we got 1 molar. Okay, so beta, here you will get your value of what? N. How much? 1 mole. So aqueous solution means what? In that contain water. So water, so molar means what? In terms of gram. So how? Suppose we have to calculate number of moles of water. So how much? 1000 gram divided by 18. So here near about is how much? 55.5. So obviously you will get what? Mole fraction of that solute. How much? 1 divided by 1 plus 55.5. So obviously after solving, how much you will get? 0.019 or 18 something you will get. So understood? Here also option is what? Your C option. So like that, these are simple numericals here. I hope you done all this numerical correctly. Now we will discuss question number 29. So in question number 29, very much important and very much easy here, whatever our question number 29. So see, how many moles of water are present in 180 gram of water. So simply as this question you discuss or you solved so many times. Okay, so in which topic are you remembering? In mole concept topic. Okay, so obviously 180 gram number of moles simply divided by what? Yes, 18. So you will get what your answer? 10 mole. Yes, you will get your answer immediately. Okay, so your option is what? C option. Understood? So after solving you will get this answer. Now we will discuss question number 30. Okay, question number 30. So see, in question number 30, if we take 44 gram of CO2, 14 gram of N2, what will be the mole fraction of CO2? Simply here, mole fraction of CO2 we want. So beta, here what will come? Mole fraction of CO2. Okay, so beta, first number of moles of CO2, then what? Number of moles of CO2 plus number of moles of your N2. Like that you will get, like that what you will get here? Number of moles of, sorry, mole fraction of CO2. So, as you have all this data, okay. So, see, 44 gram and 14 gram of N2. So, what will come? 44 divided by 44 gram of CO2. So, beta, 44 molecular mass also CO2, 44 only. Okay. So, divided by, okay. So, I have to write like this because it is in middle. So, beta, 44 divided by 44. Divided by what? Yes, here also same. Okay, plus. Plus what? Yes. 14 gram they gave. Yes. Divided by what? Into 20. So, after solving, you will get easily 2 by 3. How much? 2 by 3 answer you will get easily. Okay. But, see here. Sometimes you will get something answer in what? Something point answer you will get. But 2 by 3 only what? Understood? 2 by 3 you will get answer here. Okay. So these are very much important and easy. Okay. So we will discuss next. Our next is what? 31. Question number 31. So see here, in question number 31, which of the following is a colligative property? So see here, boiling point, vapor pressure is not a colligative property. Freezing point also, depression in freezing point is what? Colligative property. So your option is what? Small a, osmotic pressure. Okay, osmotic pressure is your what? Colligative property. Understood? So immediately you will get here an answer and you will get marks. Okay. Next, 32. Which of the following is not a colligative property? Say, as you discuss in contained part of solutions. Okay. So see here, which of the following is not a colligative property? Osmotic pressure. Elevation in boiling point, yes, elevation in boiling point also. What elevation in boiling point? Delta TB. Okay. Then a vapor pressure, yes, vapor pressure is what? Not a colligative property. And whatever D option is what? Depression in freezing point. It is also colligative property, but not. So your option is what? 32 C option, that is vapor pressure. Understood. So we will move towards next. So whatever our next. So see in that, whatever our next. Question number 33. So see Veda, in question number 33, when a substance is dissolved in a solvent, the vapor pressure of the solvent is decreased. Obviously it will decrease. This results in increase in the boiling point of the solution. See, a decrease in the boiling point of the solvent. See, the solution having higher freezing point than the solvent. And D, the solution having lower osmotic pressure than the solvent. So see here, vapor pressure, keep in mind beta, vapor pressure is inversely relation with what? Your boiling point. Inverse relation with boiling point. Means what beta? When vapor pressure will decrease, then boiling point will increase. When vapor pressure will decrease, boiling point will increase. So what will happen? If vapor pressure of the solvent decrease, then obviously your A option will come and increase in the boiling point of the solution. Got my point here? So in theory also, you study this in our NCERT also, this statement is present. You have to read this thoroughly. Okay. Then our next question number 34. A option they gave. Relative lowering of vapor pressure is independent. Okay, it is correct. The vapor pressure is not a colligative property. Yes, it is also correct. The vapor pressure of solution is lower than the vapor pressure of solvent. It is also correct. Now see, whatever small d they give, the relative vapor pressure is directly proportional to the original pressure. But according to Raoult's law, the Raoult's law, what they are saying, whatever the relative lowering in vapor pressure of a dilute solution is equal to mole fraction of the solute. Is what? Is equal to mole fraction of the solute, okay, present in the solution according to Raoult's law. So beta, it not directly proportional to the original pressure, okay, is equal to what? Mole fraction of the solute present in a solution. Okay, so therefore your D option is incorrect here. Okay, now we will see question number 35. So see here, in question number 35, which pair from the following will not form an ideal solution? So see the pair they gave, CCl4 plus SiCl4, then H2O plus C4H9OH, that is butyl alcohol, C2H5Br plus C2H5I, that is bromoethane, iodoethane, and what? C6H14 and C7H16. So whatever your small B option, that is what? Your H2O plus C4H9OH, okay, it will not form ideal solution. Why? Because your formation of hydrogen bonding between your H2O and butyl alcohol, therefore it not form an ideal solution. Okay, so we will move towards next, that is question number 36. See here, which of the following is not correct for ideal solution? Okay, not correct for ideal solution. So in only if you observe the question, then only you will get answer. Okay, here what? Delta S mixing is equal to 0 is not correct for your ideal solution. Other all are correct for ideal solution. Means what? Delta S mixing 0, delta V mixing 0. It obeys Raoult's law. Okay, so here your option A here. Understood? Your option A. Okay, so now we will see here whatever our next question, that is question number 37. So see in question number 37, say carefully, if 3 gram of glucose, if what? 3 gram of glucose having molecular weight they gave 180 is dissolving 60 gram of water at 15 degree Celsius, then the osmotic pressure of the solution, so as you know this our formula, okay, pi is equal to what? CRT. Okay, so again beta, pi is equal to C is what? N by V into RT. So again your N is what beta? Pi is equal to, we can say WB by MB. Okay, so after solving this W by MB, what you will get? Yes, RT by V. It is your what? Formula here. So beta, everything they gave, so see, here first you have to calculate number of moles. So WB means what? Your mass of solute. Then MB is what? Molecular mass. So see here, already they give 3 gram, 3 divided by molar mass, also they give glucose 180 into what will come now beta? Okay, into what? They gave here 0. Yes, R value how much in osmotic pressure in liter? 0.082. Temperature, yes, 15 plus how much? 273, that is 280 degree Celsius, divided by volume. Yes, your volume in liter we want. So beta, carefully see here, whatever 60 gram, so as you know, okay, density for water 1 gram per ml. Okay, so what will come here? That ml converted into liter, so 10⁻³. So here what will come? 60 × 10⁻³ liter. Okay, so after solving this, you will get answer. Okay, how much it is your answer? that is 6. Yes, you will get what? 6.57 atmospheric pressure after solving this. You can cross check. Okay, you will get here answer as like this. Miss Pi is what your osmotic pressure here you will get. Understood? So, after this, we will discuss question number 38. Ready for that? So, see. Question number, yes, 38. Here, they gave, I think, osmotic pressure. Okay. So, see carefully. Osmotic pressure is 0.0821 atm. Okay. Question number 38. Beta. Osmotic pressure is how much? 0.0821 atm at temperature of 300 Kelvin. Find the concentration in moles per liter. So, as you know, beta, pi is equal to what? Pi is equal to CRT. This thing you know. So, beta, here, C we have to calculate. So, C is equal to what will come? Yes, pi divided by what? R into T. Osmotic pressure, how much they gave here? Yes, 0.0821. R, how much? Okay. R, how much? That also they give. Okay, that how much? 0.082. Into temperature, how much? Yes, temperature. Your 300, they gave already 300 Kelvin. Then after solving, you will get answer. That is C option. C is equal to what will come here? See here, 0.33 into 10 raised to minus 2 gain moles per liter. Question number 38. So here you will get concentration. Okay. After solving, you will get here. Understood? So these are what your question number 38. So, like that, simple questions here. Now we will move our next, that is question number 39. So see here, in question number 39, an aqueous solution of glucose was prepared by dissolving 18 gram of glucose in 90 gram of water. Okay, the relative lowering in vapor pressure. So beta, relative lowering in vapor pressure, as you know, P naught minus P divided by, that is your what? Your relative lowering pressure, as like this, divided by what? P naught. Okay, so it's equal to what? XB. So X is your what? Yes, X is your what? Mole fraction. So mole fraction again, here we have to, you know, as a mole fraction, suppose we are going to discuss for n number of moles. So n divided by, for a component, na divided by na plus nb. So like that, here also we have to do. So see, simple, they give 18 gram of glucose and 90 gram of water. So an aqueous glucose solution of glucose was prepared by dissolving 18 gram of glucose, then relative lowering in vapor pressure. Okay, so for glucose, so like that we have to do. 18 divided by 180 divided by what? 18 divided by 180 plus how much they give? Yes, 90 divided by what? Yes, beta, for 90 is what your? For water. Okay, so after solving, you will get how much answer? 0.02. Okay, that is your what? A option. Understood? Means mole fraction we did here. Okay. So, in here number of moles, here what? Total number of moles. Okay. So, we will move towards our next. That is question number 40. So, see here, the osmotic pressure. Okay. The osmotic pressure of 5% weight by volume. Solution of cane sugar at 150 degrees Celsius. Okay. So, see here. The osmotic pressure of 5% weighed by volume solution of cane sugar at 150 degrees Celsius. So, beta, question number 40 for 150 degrees Celsius. So, here also what? Pi is equal to CRT.
pi is equal to what? CRT.
Again beta, pi is equal to what? C. N by V into RT.
So again,
pi is equal to what will come? Yes, WB by MB into what? Yes, RT divided by V. So as you know, this formula your, okay. So number of moles first, pi divided by S. Sugar, cane sugar is what? C12, H22, O11. So 342 into R, 0.0821 into temperature, yes. Temperature how much? How much they gave in degree Celsius? 150. So how much here? 423 volume. So volume what will come? 5% means 5 gram of beer, whatever solute, and in what? 100 ml of? Yes, 100 ml of beer. Whatever this weight by volume, 100 ml of beer, water. So beta is in ml, so we have to convert into liter. So what? 100 into 10 raised to minus 3 liter. So after solving this, you will get easily answer how much that something in terms of 5 point you will get. Something you will get 4.9, okay. So here actually in near about option what? 5.07, okay, atm, osmotic pressure in what? atm, understood. So like that we are going to solve here, but students facing more and more problem in converting here. Other all are okay, but whenever we have to convert into ml to liter, so this thing you have to keep in mind. Okay, so we will move towards our next, that is 41. Ready? So see here, question number 41. In osmosis, so much easy theoretical question, I'd like directly from your NCERT textbook. In osmosis, solvent molecules move from lower concentration to higher concentration. Okay, so here option is what beta here, small b for your question number 41. Okay, next here 42. Okay, so see question number 42 here. For that 42, for a dilute solution, Raoult's law stated as, say the relative vapor pressure is equal to molar fraction. Now only we saw in one question which of the following is incorrect, in that we got a D option. Okay, so we can observe here simply B option, the relative lowering of vapor pressure is equal to molar fraction of the solute. Okay, so B option here 42. Okay, so next year 43, that 43 on the basis of azeotropic mixtures. So see here 43, the azeotropic mixture of water boiling point 100 degrees Celsius and HCl boiling point 85 degrees Celsius boils at 108.5 degrees Celsius. When this mixture is distilled, it's possible to obtain with this mixture with distills. Okay, so beta, first you have to see what is the azeotropic mixture. So azeotropic mixture means what? Okay, the azeotropic mixture is constant boiling mixture. It is not possible to separate the components of azeotropic mixture by boiling. It is not possible to obtain azeotropic mixture by boiling. Separate the components, okay. So here option is what? Neither HCl nor H2O in their pure states. Okay, so here your option is what? Small d. Because here what is a constant boiling mixture. Okay, in that with the help of azeotropic mixture we can't separate. Okay, it's not possible to separate the components of azeotropic mixture by simply boiling. So your option is what beta? D here. Now we will move towards question number 44. Okay, question number 44. See, which of the following colligative properties can provide molar mass of proteins, polymer or colloids with a greater precision? Which of the following colligative properties can provide a molar mass of protein? So simply here, which relative lowering not, elevation boiling point also not, yes, small d, osmotic pressure, because that osmotic pressure in NCERT, if suppose you read, so in that also you can observe easily, okay, this question answer, macromolecules such as proteins and enzymes, okay, finding molar, their molar mass, their whatever molar mass we can find with the help of what, osmotic pressure, okay. So this osmotic pressure, pi is equal to CRT, on the basis of that we can find out molar mass of protein also. Okay, so your whatever question number 44 is what, your D, that is osmotic pressure, understood? 45, so see here in question number 45, in question number 45, the average osmotic pressure of human blood is 7.8 bar at 37 degrees Celsius. What is the concentration of an aqueous NaCl solution that could be used in boiled stream? So say, very much important here. Average osmotic pressure, here concentration we need. So pi is equal to CRT. Okay, so C again, what will form? Pi divided by what? RT. So pi they give, yes, 7.8 they give, and R, you know, beta, 0.0821. Temperature how much? 37. So 273 plus 37, yes, 310 degrees Celsius. So after solving, you will get simply 0.31 mole per liter. Yes, mole per liter you will get after solving this. Okay, now here whatever MCQ type questions are over. Now we will see whatever our 5 questions ready, the integer type questions. Okay, so see here, integer type questions. Seen that integer type questions. Question number 46. In question number 46, the amount of urea to be dissolved in 500 ml of water. Okay, so already I discussed Kf. Kf is what, beta? 1.86 Kelvin kg mole inverse. Or we can say here Kf is equal to what? 1.86 Kelvin mole inverse in 100 gram of solvent. It is also correct. To produce a depression of 0.186 in freezing point H. Okay, so here beta amount. Okay, so see here, amount how can we calculate? So before that, depression freezing point term here. So what is our delta TF is equal to, yes beta, KF into M. So this beta, small m means what? Yes, small m is what beta? Molality. So here delta TF KF into WB by MB into 1000 upon WA in grams. In where? In grams. WB, as you know, weight of solute, molar mass of the solute. Here what? Weight of solvent in grams. Okay. So here we have to calculate WB because we don't have that values. Okay. So see here, WB is equal to beta. What will come your formula? Delta TF into MB into WA. Okay. Divided by what? KF into 1000. So see here, delta TA value we have. Yes, we have 0.186 into MB we have, urea. Yes, molar mass you have to calculate, urea. NH2CO, NH2, they are what? Chemical formula. Okay, you must know this urea, NH2CO, NH2. 60, okay, then what, WA? 400 mL, so it is nearly equal to what in grams also? So into what, beta? 400. So divided by what? Kf 1.86 into 1000. So into 1000 means what here? After solving, yes, you can cross check your answer. You will get what? 3 grams, whatever your WB after solving. Okay, simple here. So like that, it is a 4 marks question. Okay, now we will move towards next. That is question number 47. Ready? So see here. Question number 47. The freezing point of 1 molar NaCl. Freezing point of 1 molar NaCl solution. Assuming NaCl to be 100% dissociated in water. So its molar depression constant they give. Molar depression constant means what? Kf they give. Is how much? We know that 1.86. Okay. So beta, here we have to calculate what? Freezing point of solution. Means Tf we have to calculate. So we will start here. See here. For that you must know this formula. Delta Tf is equal to, because NaCl they give, dissociation, I into Kf into M. You already studied this formula. Quantum factor modified this equation, I into Kf into M. So beta, here I for NaCl, how much value of I? Yes, 2. Kf already gave 1.86. Okay, into what? Molal. 1 molal. So here how much you will get, beta? 3.72. So here we have to calculate what? Freezing point of solution. So freezing point of solution, Tf is equal to what will come, beta? Okay, see, you studied this Tf naught minus what, beta? Delta Tf. So here you will get what? Solvent 0 minus delta Tf, 3.72. So what will come? 0.372. Your freezing point of 1 molar aqueous solution. Okay. So freezing point degree Celsius we ought to mention here. Understood. So we will next question number 48. So see question number 48. After adding a solute, freezing point of solution decreases to minus 0.186. Calculate the delta Tb if Kf is equal to 1.86 and Kb is what? 0.521. Okay. So for that here you must know, here no any solute they give. Therefore first you have to calculate, okay, delta Tf is equal to Kf into M. So how much they give value? 0. Yes, decreases from, so they give here values, okay, 0.186, okay, decreases to, so here how much their value they give? Kf 1.86 into what, beta? M. So here from this value how much? 0.1 you will get. Understood? So beta, delta Ta, so here what we have to calculate? Delta Tb. So delta Tb is equal to what? Kb into M. Okay, so beta, here delta Tb, Kb is what here? Yes, 0.52 into M, here already we solved 0.1. So how much here you will get? 0.05. That is your answer. So beta, after adding a solution, freezing point of solution decreases to 0.186. Okay, 0.186 freezing point. Okay, so you will get here answer how much? 0.05 only. Okay, so we will solve next. So that is next year. Question number 49. What should be the freezing point of solution containing 17 gram of Sootage 5 is in 1000 gram of water. Okay, what shall be the freezing point of aqueous solution? So again we have to do same here. Okay, as like we discuss. So see here, for that here we have to calculate delta TF only, so no issues. So delta TF is what, beta? Kf into what? M. Delta TF is equal to what? Kf into M. So again, as you know, this molality delta TF is what? Kf WB by MB into 1000 upon WA in grams. So delta TA, KF already they gave 1.86, WB how much? Yes, 17 gram, molar mass, CTH5 is 46, 1000 divided by in grams also they gave, 1000 gram, okay, 1000 gram only they gave, simple calculation. So after solving what you will get, 0.69 you will get. And here what, freezing point of aqueous solution means again your previous thing. Okay, so see here we will discuss delta TF, freezing point of solution. Okay, so TF is equal to TF naught minus delta TF. Okay, so here freezing point of solution, so 0 minus beta 0.69, what will come? Okay, 0 minus 0.69, yes, minus 0.69 here you will get degree Celsius. Okay, it is what, freezing point of your solution. Okay, and last question, point of factor of calcium nitrate. Okay, you can cross check your all answers. Last question, in integer type, point of factor for calcium nitrate, CaNO3 twice. So how it dissociate, beta? Ca2 plus plus 2NO3 minus. So this 1 plus 2, how much? Your answer is what? 3. So your point of factor I is equal to what? Yes, your I is equal to what here? Simply 3. So like this, we discuss all. If any doubt, you can ask anytime. Okay, so I hope you solved all these questions from our this topic solutions. You can feel free to ask any doubt regarding this, and you have to solve our NCERT in-text question and exercise question also. It is very much important for your CBSE upcoming exam. Okay, so thank you.